everyone. Welcome to Tech Topics. My name is Stefan, and today we're going to be talking a little bit about a new feature coming in NOS 4.1 called Metro Availability. This is a feature that provides synchronous replication between two Nutanix clusters, which is beneficial in cases where a site-wide failure is seen and you need to have your data protected. Some other features that this mechanism provides is continuous availability in the case of a disaster strikes. And so, as I said, if a site were to go down, your data would still be available on the remote site and it would be up to date. Some other features is of Metro Availability is you'd be able to have a spanned data store across both of your sites, which would allow you to vMotion and clone VMs without any downtime. You could do those operations live. Some prerequisites you'll need before setting up Metro Availability. You need at least two Nutanix clusters to configure Metro Availability. You also need a WAN link that connects both of the clusters together, and you also have to have a remote site configured on both clusters to connect them. One last prerequisite is that the WAN link must have below 5 milliseconds of latency for Metro Availability to work properly. So let's go to the whiteboard and let's cover a scenario that illustrates the importance of Metro Availability and why it would be beneficial for you to use.
All right, so here we have two sites, both of which have two 4-node Nutanix blocks set up at the site. And what's important to know about these two sites is there are two containers configured on each site. One container is non-Metro enabled. The other containers are Metro enabled. What this means is that as data is written into the Metro container on the Atlanta side, it's automatically synchronized to the container on the New York side. So what does that mean for us? That means that if the Atlanta site were to suddenly go down due to an outage, two things would happen. Your data in container one would be unavailable. It is not protected by Metro Availability. However, the data that was written to this container already exists on the New York side. It's protected by Metro Availability. That means that if the site were to go down, your data is still here on the New York site intact and ready to be used in case you need to do a site migration or something like that. So let's go through how to configure this via Prism. We'll do a quick demo and we can show you how to set this up on your Nutanix clusters. So here we have cluster one, and this window is cluster two. And these are two separate Nutanix clusters. Step one in configuring this is you have to create the containers first. An important item to note when creating the containers for Metro Availability is the container names on the primary and secondary cluster should be the same name. If they're not the same name, the configuration won't work. And so in this instance, I'm just going to call them test_metro_1. Once you configure the containers, the next step is to verify that a remote site is configured for connecting between the two clusters. And essentially, that's all the remote site is. It's a mechanism to be able to connect to the cluster that you're replicating to. And in this instance, the remote site's already created. So we have a remote site here. And the IP address 10.63.4.37 is the IP address of one of the CVMs on the secondary cluster. And if we go to the secondary cluster, we also see that there's a remote site created in order to connect itself to the primary cluster. And so this cluster connects to 10.63.2.211, which is an IP address of the CVM on the primary. After you've created your remote site, the next step is to create your Metro configuration. And so by doing that, you'll go to the top right here, select Protection Domain, and you're going to select Metro Availability. The name here is not the name of the container. This is simply the name of the Metro container that you'll be creating and provisioning. So we're going to call this Test Metro Availability 1. The next button is going to ask you which container do you want to use for Metro. And in this case, we're going to use test_metro_1. And when the configuration is completed, it checks the secondary cluster to make sure there's a container of the same name. And that's the part that will fail if you don't line up the container names properly. Step three is going to be selecting the remote site. You'll see here that there's a compatible remote site section and an incompatible remote site section. What's important to note here is that the remote site has a latency greater than 5 milliseconds. It's not eligible to be selected for Metro Availability. This item here indicates what the cluster should do in the event of a network failure or a failure on the secondary or primary clusters. As it says here, if there's a network failure or a site failure on the standby site, the writes to the primary container will halt. And there's two ways you can clear that condition. You can tell the cluster to say, hey, manually clear this condition, or wait for me to manually intervene, or B, automatically separate and break the metro configuration after X amount of time. This can be anywhere between 10 to 30 seconds. For this scenario, we'll do 10 seconds. And the last item is just a review, and make sure that the configuration you entered, the names, and also the IP addresses are proper. This is also an important item to note here. So when you initiate the first transfer of your metro container, the contents of the secondary container will be overwritten by the contents of the primary container. So if you have already created a container for metro on the secondary cluster and have data inside that container, that data will be overwritten as soon as you activate the metro availability. And so that's just important to note, that if you've placed data in those containers, you should remove it before enabling metro. And that's it. For more information, check out the web console guide on portal.nutanix.com, which has some additional details on metro availability. Thanks for watching Tech Topics.